and Christmas.
Okay.
And it is a big part of this scene. A lot of people step back and saying, this isn't Halloween. Let's not talk about ghosts and Christmas.
And they're completely wrong.
They are completely and utterly wrong. There are about 100 to 200, if not more, stories out there, ghost stories, that are around Christmas time. And one of the reasons people think that maybe ghosts are more active around Christmas time, because there are more actual paranormal encounters on Christmas than there is Halloween, Day of the Dead. The days are shorter, and the sun and the moon and all this stuff are closer to each other than any other time of the year. Or maybe it's the fact. Now, if you guys haven't watched this movie, I'm not personally going to watch it. There's a movie out there about this kid dying, and how that when you pass away, you actually turn back into your child form when you're up in the paranormal afterlife. And that would make sense why there is a lot of activity around that time, because when you were a kid, what was your favorite holiday?
Well,
most of them, 95% of them, it was Christmas. So you could come back to your house, which probably has people in that you don't recognize, and see the Christmas tree there and see the kid unwrapping presents that you don't recognize. And, of course, you're going to throw that ever so popular six-year-old tantrum because nothing around you is what it used to be back into the 1860s, 1870s, even before that. So none of this you recognize inside this old house. Maybe it's a newer house that's built on an older one. You don't even recognize that. Is that the possibility? I don't know. But even when you're listening to the songs and carols and everything, they're talking about telling ghost stories by the fire. Because there's nothing more entertaining than getting the living schnitz scared out of you.
Well, absolutely. I mean, I'll agree to that 100%. The other thing about Christmas, why is there more activity and so on, paranormal, is because, like you pointed out, Chuckles, Christmas was originally not a Christian holiday.
Nope.
I mean, we're talking about, you know, the Christmas tree goes back to, what, the Norse mythology.
Goes way back to the Vikings.
Way back to the Vikings and probably before that, right? Yeah. The nature worship. In other words, there's a lot of spiritual activity connected with December 25th that has nothing to do with the Christian. I mean, the Christian religion they knew better than to try to just wipe away all the old traditions. So what they did is they just did a thin overlay of Christianity over the old pagan traditions. And
right.
that's why that's why there's a lot of spiritual activity around this time of year.
Now, here's one for you all you, that's a nice word of saying this, devout Christians out there. If you have a Christmas tree in your house, you are celebrating a pagan ritual.
You pagan son of a...
That goes all the way back, like you said, to the Vikings, where they thought that when the trees lost their leaves. Now, the pagans looked at Mother Nature like us Wiccans did. They looked at them as their gods, Mother Nature, whatnot. They had different gods for each one. So they would decorate the evergreens, pine trees, with sacrifices or whatever they had at the moment. They would decorate these trees with hopes that these sacrifices and decorations would bring the leaves back to the forest.
Right, and the reason they emphasized the evergreens is for that exact reason.
They didn't lose their needles. So that was one of the reasons they thought they were super beings of Mother Nature. That brings back to even earlier where people talk about trees coming alive and all that stuff and these Lord of the Rings and all that stuff. The Vikings were talking about that even before it was a special at the movie theater. So if you have one of those trees in your house, you are definitely celebrating a pagan ritual. And then you go even further into it with the lights on it, which has a lot to do with the Wiccan religion of putting the lights on the tree. So shame on you, you bigot son of a gun out there. You throw these words out there, and yet you have this tree in you, in your house. And there are a couple friends that I know that are devout that will not put the tree up there because it is a pagan thing. But for the most part, everybody goes back there and does that, and they don't even recognize what it's there for.
And don't forget, as you said before, all the candles.
Yep. Now, that had to be dangerous. Now, if you guys don't know, a Christmas tree has lots of oils on it, and it combusts really easily.
Yeah, I used to set ours on fire as soon as my dad took it out. And my dad, by the way, hated Christmas as much as Chuckles the Clown. Like, he tolerated it for the sake of when we were real little kids, and that's about it. So the day after Christmas, that Christmas tree was thrown out in the backyard.
No.
So, and I like nothing more than to get a match and like light that sucker up as soon as it dried out.
Public service announcement from Chuckles Crypt. Do not do that. Do not do that in your house. It will make for a very cold holiday and rest of the winter.
Do not do it in your house. Do not do it in your backyard.
No.
Throw it out on the front sidewalk where the, then you can burn that. It's safer there.
Yeah, so that way when the police and the fire department comes around, they arrest you for arson. Good idea, George.
You run.
Have you seen
You these? Don't throw it in front of your own
have
house.
Have you seen these kids? Do they look like they can run now? Do they even look like they can start a fire in these day and ages? They're going to have to go up and ask an adult how to do it, and then that adult's going to get pinned, probably someone like you, that remembers how to light the fire, and they're gonna slowly waddle away, and you're going to be sitting there keeping warm by the tree, and you're going to be the one getting arrested.
No, it's probably a really good idea that I don't have children.
Yeah.
Because I'd be serving them the alcohol in the basement, lighting Christmas trees with them.
Do you even live by kids?
Do what?
Do you live by any children in your neighborhood, in an apartment?
No, as a matter of fact, I don't right now.
That's a good thing for you. That really is.
Yes, I can't be a positive influence.
No, I thought I was a bad influence, but you, George, you, on the other hand, you need the clown paint more than I do. And I'm saying that as a compliment. You should next year.
I took it that exact way.
George should be throwing on the evil clown paint and showing these kids how to do things.
I know I had a very good time when I was a kid.
And we did. We really did. But some of this stuff is really dangerous. And that's what I was getting to is those lights on those trees, the candles that you put on, how many countless house fires do you think that had happened back in those 200, 300, 400 years ago? And they didn't have fire departments to come put out your house. And 9 times out of 10, their house roofs were made out of straw or some other very flammable product.
Well, basically, yeah. So first of all, you had the candles. Lit candles on a combustible Christmas tree.
Right.
Inside a house made out of wood, roof made out of straw, and maybe that's where they came up with the original human sacrifice, burnt offering.
I don't know. Maybe that's where they came up with the Christmas tree star, because afterwards it was glowing so bright, they came up with the idea this is a star on the tree. I don't know. It just doesn't seem like a smart idea to me. If I was doing that, I would probably be lighting the lights out in my yard. That way, if it goes up, hey, it's entertainment. Otherwise, no. We're going to try this again with the music before we wrap things up. I know we're getting really close to that. Again, everybody out there, I will be back the 23rd along with George Garner. But
22nd, 23rd?
Whatever day, the 22nd. Okay, I'm a clown. I'm stupid, all right? So we'll be back
in
20 seconds.
Yeah, but we're stupid people that want our audience.
Now, we've messed up all night. Don't be dragging on me for one slip-up. This whole thing has been a giant cluster F-bomb, if you don't know what I mean.
Live but December 22nd.
Live. No, I won't be live. I'll be dead. You'll be alive. Don't insult me like that. But before we get to that, we're going to try this one more time. We're going to go down to Weird Al, the night Santa went crazy. And if you guys keep poking at me, Santa won't be the only one going crazy here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio. It'll be me going crazy.
The elves were making toys for the good Gentile girls and the good Gentile boys. When the boss busted in, nearly scared him half to death. Had a rifle in his hands and cheap whiskey on his breath. From his beard to his boots, he was covered with ammo. Like a big, fat, drunk, disgruntled Yuletide Rambo. And he smiled as he said, with a twinkle in his eye, Merry Christmas to all, now you're all gonna die. The night Santa went crazy, the night Saint Nick went insane. Realized he'd been getting the wrong deal, something finally must have snapped in his brain. Well, the workshop is gone now, he decided to bomb it. Everywhere you'll find pieces of Cupid and Comet. And he tied up his helpers, and he held the elves hostage. And he ground up a room into reindeer sausage. He got Dancer and Prancer with an old German Luger, and he slashed up Dasher just like Freddy Krueger. And he picked up a flamethrower and a barbecue blitzer, and he took a big bite and said it tastes just to be such a jolly guy. Yes, Virginia, now Santa's doing time in a federal prison for his infamous crime. Hey, little friend, now don't you cry no more tears. He'll be out with good behavior in 700 more years. But now Vixen's in therapy and Donner's still nervous, and the elf all got jobs working for the postal service. And they say Mrs. Claus, she's on the phone every night with a lawyer negotiating the movie rights. They talk about the night Santa went crazy, the night St. Nicholas slipped, broke his back for some milk and cookies. Sounds to me like he was tired of getting chipped.
Right, that was Weird Al Yankovic, and that was The Night Santa Went Crazy here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio, and we are almost out of time, very close to it. However, something that has successfully withstand time is the Chuckles and Laugh Show, and if you are local to us, even in New Bedford, and you're listening to this, we are celebrating our five-year anniversary marker Monday, and that will be at 10:30, and that's Cox Communications, Verizon. If you guys know the stations, it's 13 and 32. It's up there. I'm not really quite sure about New Bedford's. I got to learn that. But we're rocking our five-year anniversary. Not only 5 years producing a show, but 5 years of no repeats. We have come close to making more shows than Monday Night Raw has in this five-year period. And we haven't repeated a single one. So bravo out there to the Chuckles and Laughs Show fans for watching us and putting up with us for 5 years. And bravo to the inmates for putting up with me. We're getting close to the end of the night, and I told you I would talk a little bit about My Night Out Radio, my friends Psycho Eddie and George Nassar, but we'll have to wait for that another time. However, if you want to hear more of us, myself and George will switch spots. I will be in the co-pilot seat, and you will be in the pilot seat on the Haunted Cabaret, where I guarantee you the stuff that comes out of this man's mouth even sometimes makes the evil clown go silent.
And tonight will be no exception.
No, there will not. And I have a couple things I'd like to share with you as well, some experiences that aren't really Chuckles Crypt friendly, but they definitely fit in with the Haunted Cabaret, because I am an evil clown, and the Haunted Cabaret is my second home. Actually, third, more like fourth home. Got a lot of homes, a lot of candles lit up there. We're going to wrap the night up here on Chuckles Crypt, and we will be back the 22nd live again. And hopefully that stupid gremlins that have been in this sound booth don't mess up the stuff again, or I'm going to pour water all over them. We're going to wrap things up with a fellow that I am shocked has a Christmas album. Very shocked. And I know some of you are not, but I was. For my own reasons, here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio, happy horror days, and I look forward to hearing from you guys again the 22nd. Here is Twisted Sister, Oh Come All Ye Beautiful. I'm not saying that.